Welcome back. Big three automaker Ford today announcing that it will be investing more than $1 billion to upgrade three Michigan factories, as well as adding 130 jobs to help run them. President Trump was quick to applaud the plan, claiming it is proof that his economic strategy is working. But is there actually a better way to bring back the millions of manufacturing jobs we've lost in the last few decades? There could be, and it involves ending the belief that Americans are entitled to go to college and instead pushing for them to attend vocational schools and that type of training. Well, let me welcome to the program Mike Rowe. You probably recognize him as the host of Dirty Jobs, but he's also the host of a podcast called The Way I Heard It and the CEO of the Mike Rowe Works Foundation.
Also true.
Mike
yes.
Rowe, your boat right into my studio.
Wow, with the metaphors.
Thank you for being here.
You got me so bad in your open, filling the orifices of the body politic, was it?
Yes.
Not bad.
Exploring, it might have been.
Either way. Well, first you explore. Then you feel.
Then you feel, exactly right. It's a logical progression. So, Mike Rowe, you have a generation of people that the other generations, baby boomers and Gen Xers, think millennials are entitled and they think they all are special and need to go to college.
Mm-hmm.
But that is not necessarily the most fruitful path because you end up with a lot of debt and very few employment opportunities, and you have been pushing for people to learn vocational skills, which I think is a great idea because you make a lot more money.
You don't even need me here for this.
I do.
You know, you did it perfectly. That's it. No, look, it was Porgy who said it ain't necessarily so, right? And
didn't even need Beth.
How obscure can I get? But yeah, it's, look, there's a ton of opportunity in the country.
Yeah.
And in my humble view of all the divides currently dividing us, the big divide is between the people who are convinced opportunity's dead and those who are fairly convinced it's not. I'm over here. And I think 5.6 million available jobs in what's called the skills gap is proof positive. I think the fact that 75% of those jobs don't require a four-year degree is further proof positive. And I would further posit that $1.3 trillion of existing student loans on the other end of things might suggest that we've been lending money we don't have to kids who can't pay it back to educate them for jobs that don't exist
anymore. Yeah, into a system that has no way of policing itself, keeps growing and sucking more money from government and families. But let's talk about some of these jobs because these are not STEM jobs. These are not engineering jobs. These are jobs that you say require work. How do we make calloused hands sexy again?
Well, first of all, you challenge the acronym. STEM gets a lot of press, but, you know, why not STEMs? Why not put skills on the end of it?
Yeah.
Better yet, why not STEAMs? Because when you take the art out of the vocational arts, you're just left with the vocation, which is kind of the opposite of a vacation. So you set the table by saying to people, there's a whole category of consolation prizes we call these types of jobs, which ironically are tied to the same kinds of education we call alternative education. So from a very, very early age, parents and guidance counselors make it clear that there's a path for people who aren't cut out for that which is most desired.
Yeah, and the desired path is really the only one, and that's the one that so many kids are forced into who aren't ready for college, who aren't served by spending four years in one place studying things they don't care about.
Right, because if you're running for office, right, you have to deliver a macro message.
Yeah.
You have to say something that makes the most possible sense to the largest group of people. But the problem is actually a micro problem, if you will, you know, because it's a cookie cutter approach to education is killing us.
Yeah.
And when people
not only on the primary and secondary level, which, you know, we talk about a lot in this country, it's outdated. That's why parents want school choice. But also when you talk about higher education,
especially in higher education, look, people always say, how did it get so expensive? How did tuition get more expensive than energy, food, real estate and healthcare? And the answer is because we told a whole generation the best path for you is the most expensive path,
and
then we freed up endless money.
Yeah,
right?
but you have, it feels like endless money. You've got $500,000, and you're telling kids, you know, come,
you know,
take my money, please.
Do you know how hard it is to give away work ethic scholarships? We've done it for 4 years. We've raised about $4 million, and every year we got a modest pile, about $500,000.
Yeah, that's a lot of money.
And they're not big allotments. You know, it could be anywhere between $2,000 and $15,000, depending on the applicant. But we just want to focus training money on jobs that actually and currently exist that just don't get a lot of love, because half the welders that went through our program, they're north of six figures.
Yeah, no, they're making, you said it's easy to make $140,000 a year. My nephew, God bless him, he's one of these kids who was not cut out for school.
Yeah.
So he's in a vocational school where he's learning carpentry over right. 2.5 years, and he's a year into the program, and he's already building houses. I mean, he's getting on-the-job training, and, you know, this kid is going to have skills and a job and a future.
And one other thing. No debt.
Yeah, that's right.
We're very, very little. See, look, every time I have this conversation, what comes back over the net is you're anti-college, or worse, you're anti-education.
Yeah.
So if I could look earnestly into the camera and just say for a moment, there is no hope without education.
Mm-hmm.
You have to have some sort of useful skill. But this idea that the only place to get the best education is the most expensive place.
Yeah.
It's killing us.
And it's a bunch of hot malarkey, so you need hot mops and
malarkey.
Vocational jobs. Mike Rowe, it's so nice to see you in person.
Please go to my website and apply for a work ethic scholarship.
Very good.
The money's burning a hole in my pocket, honestly.
What's the website?
I don't know.
Exactly right.
Go to microworks.com. You'll find it.
And not micro, it's Mike Rowe.
Like my name.
There he is.
There
All right.
Go.
Thanks again.
You're welcome.
Loved having you. Come back, please.